And just like that, the world lost another legend. We're still in shock after hearing Henry Gartland's passing. These terrible, horrible things always seem to happen, or feel like they always happen, to the nicest, loving, most humble people around us. Talented people. Ever since his passing, almost everyone has reposted Henry Gartland, and in the caption, urging others to call the suicide prevention hotline, which is a great, great tool. Do not misunderstand this video. It is a great tool that has proven to help and have saved hundreds of lives every single year by using the hotline. However, I do beg and urge that we entertain the idea that in skateboarding, there's an asterisk as to how well we can flag potential risk factors when it comes to suicide signs. But in order to talk about this, we need to understand why people even commit suicide to begin with. According to verywellmind.com, articles approved by MDs from Massachusetts explain that mental illness is the primary cause why somebody may take their lives as the primary motivating factor. Severe depression is really the main contributor. Now, what are some of the main mental illnesses or main signs, aversions of depression? Primarily, bipolar disorder. It is estimated that nearly 30% of everyone diagnosed at some point in their lives with bipolar disorder will attempt to commit suicide at least once in their lives. 30%. According to the report that article was extracted from, Cambridge notes that risk factors, whenever you notice and identify signs on people / patients, can reduce suicidal risk, but ongoing clinical assessment is essential to limit the actual risk. In other words, it's good that you can pay attention and see signs that something is going on with your loved one, with your friend, with your relative, etc. But it's not until you get professional help that you're actually doing something about it, something tangible, something that actually helps the situation or prevents, I guess, worse things from happening. Just by going on YouTube and searching for mental health and skateboarding, you quickly realize this is not an isolated situation. How mental illness derailed the career of a promising young skateboarder. We talk about Paul Alexander in this video and how he was extremely, extremely talented from a very, very young age. He was already basically setting himself apart from others. And people can talk about this and say how he was just amazing. So many similar comments and vibes from him.
They just know there's something different about him.
The highest pop I've probably still ever seen.
He was just unbelievably ahead of his time. Couldn't even fathom how you could do shit like that so effortlessly.
Oh my God! Oh, yeah.
I don't really know what happened, really, with when he wasn't around and stuff.
You know, people still talk about him, people still reminisce about him and stuff, for sure. Like,
I knew he'd had his battles, you know? Because you'd see him come out, he'd be here, he'd skate, and he'd be gone.
Gone. The story of Paul Alexander. As you were able to see a correlation that I've witnessed myself, and perhaps you witnessed too, that some of the best skateboarders that you'll ever see, whether it's in person or through a screen, have some type of either autism or mental condition that somehow they learn how to hack and they use it, you know, for their benefit in skateboarding and to have a career or just to enjoy themselves while skateboarding, which is great, but could also take a very dark detour when it comes to their overall health. And this is just one example, Paul Alexander. Along with this, there is a video very similar as well from Vice on Billy Rohan. I hope I'm saying that correctly. And again, another case of an extremely talented young man that was battling with bipolar disorder. Here's a little clip of this video.
The very first time I realized something was off balance was during a skate tour in Europe. I was in Germany and got pulled over for drinking and driving, did a backflip off the cop car to like show that I wasn't drunk. And that got me put right into a hospital there. That was the first time I had diagnosed with manic depression or bipolar disorder. Being an alcoholic or using drugs, I always blamed it on those two things. And so I would stay sober and things would go well. But when it happened, even without drinking, that's when I knew something was up.
That is one of the problems / inconveniences when living a life, quote unquote, like the, you know, thrasher hardcore skater. And if there is a mental condition in this person's life, in their mind, that is a huge problem because it can easily be camouflaged. It can easily go undetected. In the case of Billy, he clearly said, I was starting to notice my behavior because I was being pulled over for, you know, drinking and driving or just driving under the influence. And he just, you know, was acting out crazy. But he would blame it on the substance abuse. Now, the video goes along by saying how sometimes when it would happen, whenever he wasn't under any substance, is whenever he started picking up, like, there's probably something a lot more sinister happening. He even goes to mention that he thought about ending it all because he lost everything due to his mental illness. I feel like as number one, men, and number two, skateboarders, we don't want to be that buzzkill. We don't want to be that party pooper. We don't want to be the person to be such a downer. And we'd rather just save our comments, save our statements.
Even your friends will be trying to explain to you, like, hey man, I think there's something wrong. And if I didn't have friends this last time that took everything from my apartment and put it into storage while I was in the hospital, I would have literally lost everything that I've ever worked for in my life. Your friends is what keeps you from being like, fuck it, I wish I was dead.
Man, that's pretty raw and pretty rough. Billy just said it himself. Your friends are actually the ones that can prevent you from taking a path of no return. And it doesn't stop with these two individuals. You just keep going. And even more recently, Skate Rats, along with Transworld, put out a mental health awareness edit where it's dedicated to Smotag or Sean, a Seattle skateboarder that they were very, very dear and close to. And he basically committed suicide as well. And they made this montage, this video, to raise awareness about mental health. So this is not an isolated situation. And it's so tragic that we think about these things and we repost them, and which is good to raise awareness, but what is the true action that we take beyond that? What are we actually doing to make sure that this doesn't repeat itself? I'm pretty sure Henry's friends, people that knew him the closest, perhaps some could tell something was up, perhaps the closest people to him, whether they were traveling with him, whether family members, perhaps they did know he had some kind of issue he was battling through, but they probably didn't think he was going to take his life. I mean, that's so bizarre. That's so extreme until it happens. And then there's nothing you can do about it then. While I'm not bashing the suicide lines, while I'm not bashing these organizations that are there to help, just remember that medicine and treatment doesn't work if you don't take it. Hospitals can't help you if you're not admitted. The suicide prevention line can't be of use if you don't call. But friends, people close to you, people that love you, people that know you, perhaps you may not have a ton of friends, you may not be Mr. Popular, but arguably, almost every single person out there has somebody else that really cares for them. In your case, somebody that cares for you, somebody that loves you, and people that you love. And that influence that you have in person as a human being, not as an organization, not as a hotline, not as treatment, but as an individual, you have the greatest influence to check on people. Tell them you love them. Tell somebody how much they mean to you. Tell them how the world would be different if they weren't here anymore, and how you wouldn't want to live in a world like that. When was the last time you told somebody those words? It doesn't cost much. A text, a phone call, a post or a comment. It's a very, very cheap, inexpensive method of potentially saving someone's life. Rest in peace, Henry. You will be missed. I'm the Skate Informant. You've been informed, and I love you all.